Hello friends, welcome to the Vaivavas of Anatomy. Here I will discuss the external features of the cerebellum and also the anatomical, functional and the morphological subdivisions of the cerebellum. So first the location of the cerebellum. So you can see this is the sagittal section of the head and neck. Now the cerebellum is the part of hindbrain and located in the posterior cranial fossa just below the tentorium cerebelli. This is the tentorium cerebelli. And behind the pons and the medulla, but cerebellum is separated from the pons and the medulla by this cavity of the fourth ventricle, and the cerebellum is connected with the brain stem through the three pairs of cerebellar peduncles, with the midbrain through the superior cerebellar peduncle, with the pons through the middle cerebellar peduncles, and with the medulla through the inferior cerebellar peduncles. Now the cerebellum consist of outer side cortical gray matter, here you can see outer side is the gray matter, and medullary core of white matter. So inner side is the white matter and outer side is the gray matter, and you can see this outer side cortical gray matter thrown into numerous transverse folds. Here you can see these are the folds, this one clear, numerous transverse folds are there. And these folds are known as the pollium, and this pollium or transverse folds are separated by the fissures. Here you can see this is the fissure, this is the fissure, this is the fissure, okay. So pollium and fissures are there, and this inner side medullary core of white matter extend into the central axis of each fold like this. You can see this white matter extend into the gray matter. So this type of pattern looks like a branching of trees, and that's why this pattern is known as arbor vitae cerebelli. Now this cortical gray matter contains the neurons like a stellate cell, basket cell, then the Purkinje cells, Golgi cells, granule cells, okay. And these cells are arranged into the layers like molecular layer, Purkinje cell layer, and the granular layer. And the medullary core of white matter contains the deep cerebellar nuclei. From medial to lateral side, these nuclei are nucleus fastigii, nucleus globosus, nucleus emboliformis, and the nucleus dentatus, from medial to lateral side on each side. Now about the anatomical subdivision of the cerebellum. So the cerebellum consists of two large cerebellar hemispheres. And in the median plane, worm-like vermis is there. Here you can see, this is the vermis, worm-like vermis. Now, the superiorly, the vermis is continuous with the lateral surface of this hemisphere. So, we can't demarcate this vermis on the superior surface from this surface of the hemisphere. But inferiorly, we can clearly demarcate the vermis from the surfaces of the hemisphere, and it shows the deep furrow inferiorly, and this deep furrow is known as the valleicula, clear. So here you can see this is the superior surface of the cerebellum, and here is the inferior surface of the cerebellum. Here I have just separated the cerebellum from the rest of the parts of the brain. Now, the cerebellum first divided by one fissure is known as the posterolateral fissure. So, here you can see inferiorly, this is the posterolateral fissure, this one, which divides the cerebellum into the proculonodular lobe and corpus cerebelli. So here you can see this is the proculus, this is the proculus, and these two proculus on each side connected with the nodule. Here you can see this is the nodule through the inferior medullary velum. So here you can see this is the inferior medullary velum on each side. Okay, so this is the floculonodular lobe and remaining all part of cerebellum. So this whole part is known as the corpus cerebelli. Now this corpus cerebelli is further subdivided into two lobes, anterior lobe and posterior lobe, by V-shaped fissure prima. So here you can see this is the V-shaped fissure prima, which divides the corpus cerebelli into the anterior lobe, this anterior part, and this posterior part, remaining part. This one is the posterior lobe. Now, anterior lobe. So, in the vermal zone, the anterior lobe consists of three parts from anterior to posterior side. First is the lingula, this one, then the central lobule and the culmen. So, this lingula has a no lateral projection on each side, but the remaining two parts have a lateral projection. Clear? So central lobule has a lateral projection on each side, is known as the ala. Then the culmen has a lateral projection on each side, known as the quadrangular lobule. So this is about the anterior lobe. Now about the posterior lobe. This is the V-shaped fissure prima. So this remaining part, this one, is the posterior lobe. Now in the posterior lobe, the vermal part consists of declive, then the folium vermis, then the tuber vermis, then the pyramid and the eula. Last is the eula. So these are the vermal parts of the posterior lobe. Each vermal part has a lateral projection on each side, and respectively this lateral projection are the lobulus simplex, then superior semilunar lobule, then the inferior semilunar lobule, then the biventral lobule, and lastly is the tonsil. This is the tonsil on each side. So this is about the anterior lobe and the posterior lobe. Now one more fissure is there, is known as the horizontal fissure. So here you can see this is the horizontal fissure, this one, which divides the cerebellum into the two surfaces. So this part is the superior surface and this part is the inferior surface. Now the morphological subdivision of the cerebellum. So morphologically the cerebellum divided into the three parts: archicerebellum, paleocerebellum and the neocerebellum. So this archicerebellum, also known as the vestibular cerebellum, paleocerebellum, also known as the spinal cerebellum, and the neocerebellum, also known as the cerebropontine cerebellum. So this archicerebellum includes the floculonodular lobe, this one, floculonodular lobe, and the lingula, this one. And this archicerebellum receives the input from the vestibular nerve and the medial and inferior vestibular nuclei. And this archicerebellum concerned with the maintenance of equilibrium, tone, and the posture of trunk muscles. Then next is the paleocerebellum. It is also known as the spinal cerebellum. And paleocerebellum includes the whole anterior lobe, this whole anterior lobe, except the pyramid and the eula. And this paleocerebellum receives the input from the proprioceptive and exteroceptive fibers from the spinocerebellar tract, both anterior and posterior spinocerebellar tract, cuneocerebellar tract, and from the rostral spinocerebellar tract. So this paleocerebellum concerned with the muscle tone and posture of limbs. And last part is the neocerebellum, also known as the cerebropontine cerebellum. एंड दिस पार्ट इंक्लूड दी ऑल पार्ट्स ऑफ द सेरेबेलम एक्सेप्ट द पार्ट्स विच आर इंक्लूडिंग इन द आर्किसेरेबेलम एंड द पैलियो सेरेबेलम एंड दिस नियो सेरेबेलम रिसीव्स द इनपुट फ्रॉम द पॉन्टाइन न्यूक्लियाई एंड इन्फीरियर ऑलिवरी न्यूक्लियस एंड ऑल्सो रिसीव्स द इनपुट फ्रॉम द विजुअल एंड द ऑडिटरी सेंसेस सो दिस नियो सेरेबेलम कंसर्न विद द स्मूथ परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ स्किल एक्ट बाय कोऑर्डिनेशन ऑफ मूवमेंट्स सो मॉर्फोलॉजिकली आर्किसेरेबेलम पैलियो सेरेबेलम एंड द नियो सेरेबेलम आर देयर आर्किसेरेबेलम कंसर्न विद द ट्रंक मसल्स पैलियो सेरेबेलम कंसर्न विद द लिम मसल्स एंड द नियो सेरेबेलम कंसर्न विद द परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ स्किल एक्ट नाउ अबाउट द फंक्शनल सब डिविजन ऑफ द सेरेबेलम सो वी नो दैट द फ्लोक्युलो नोड्यूलर लोब विच इज इंटीग्रेटेड विद द वेस्टिबुलर सिस्टम सो द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ सेरेबेलम नोन एज द कॉर्पस सेरेबेलाई विच इज सब डिवाइडेड लॉन्जिट्यूडनली इंटू द थ्री जोन्स फंक्शनली सो इन द मीडियन प्लेन इज द वर्मल जोन और मीडियन जोन देन अ पेयर ऑफ पैरावर्मल जोन और इंटरमीडिएट जोन एंड लास्ट इज द लेटरल जोन दिस वन ऑन ईच साइड और द पेयर ऑफ हेमिस्फेयर पेयर ऑफ हेमिस्फेयर नाउ फर्स्ट द मीडियन जोन और वर्मल जोन विच प्रोजेक्ट्स इंटू द न्यूक्लियस फास्टिजियाई एंड इट इज कंसर्न विद द मूवमेंट्स ऑफ द ट्रंक and also the extensor muscle torn through the vestibulospinal and the reticulospinal tract. Then next is the intermediate zone or the paravermal zone on each side which projects into the nucleus interpositus. Now what is nucleus interpositus? So this nucleus globosus and nucleus involuformis which is collectively known as the nucleus interpositus. So this intermediate zone projects into the nucleus interpositus and concerned with the ipsilateral movements and the flexor muscle tone of the limb muscles through the rubrospinal tract. And last is the lateral zone or hemisphere which projects into the nucleus dentatus and concerned with the coordination of distal limb muscles for skillful act through the dentato-rubro-thalamocortical pathway and the descending corticospinal and the rubrospinal tract. So this is about the functional subdivisions. So in the last summary, so the cerebellum anatomically subdivided into the floculonodular lobe and the corpus cerebelli by this posterolateral fissure. And this corpus cerebelli is further subdivided into two lobes, anterior lobe and posterior lobe by V-shaped fissure prima, anterior lobe and this is the posterior lobe. And the cerebellum is divided into two surfaces, superior surface and the inferior surface by this horizontal fissure. Morphologically, the cerebellum is divided into archicerebellum known as the vestibular cerebellum, paleocerebellum also known as the spinal cerebellum and neocerebellum also known as the cerebropontine cerebellum. And functionally, the cerebellum is divided into median zone or vermal zone projected into nucleus fastigiae, then the paravermal zone or intermediate zone projected into the nucleus interpositus, and last is the lateral zone which is projected into the nucleus dentatus. So this is all about the external features and the subdivisions of the cerebellum. Thank you.
If you like our video, click on the like button and share with your friends. To get the regular updates on anatomy video by Viva Voice of Anatomy, subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon.